pay homage. Top of the move, started at the bottom. Dreamt of a Hellcat, now I got it. Dreamt of a Corvette, now I got it. Taking big leaps of faith, no doubts about it. Made my mama proud, made my mama proud. Every time she see me, nigga, she just cracks a smile. I made my mama proud, made my mama proud. Every time she see me, she just cracks a smile. Nigga,
three up. Top of the Mook podcast back. My dog, Mr. Organic and Tall Guy.
3M.
Top of the Mook.
.com. RIP Little Richard.
Oh, damn. He did go out, didn't he?
Yeah, with a bang, too.
Yeah, man. RIP to Little Richard. But yeah, how you doing, brother?
Man, I'm doing pure. I can't really complain right now, man. Everything is optimistic. Everything is, you know, is viral, I would say.
So tell him, why can't you complain? It's definitely viral.
Man, it's a moment of reflection, you know. I'm getting my dream car today, you know what I mean?
What's that?
Rolls Royce Wraith. Rolls Royce. How you say Rolls Royce? Damn,
who just done Wraith? And it's a car that he's been wanting from the beginning, from the seed. You know what I mean? Come on, 3M, we on the podcast, brother. You know you're the terrible multitasker.
Yeah, motherfuckers just harassed me, man. I don't know what's going on. But yeah, Rolls Royce Wraith. I can't wait to do it. Can't wait to get to it, man. Extra blessed. I don't know. It was a real goddamn, like, it's a somber feeling and a super goddamn exciting feeling at the same time. Right. It's just like, you just sit back and chill, like, man, your expectations be so high, but you know that everything's possible. So now you're like, damn, was my like, thoughts too small? Like, I did this pretty quick on the grind, you know? But once you realize, no, you did a whole bunch of hustling, man. Don't get him fucked up. You just seeing right now. You seeing the last 3 years. You ain't seeing your whole life. Mm-hmm. You ain't seeing really where you came from. You ain't seeing all that sacrifice. You ain't seeing everybody around you ain't get it like this. You know what I mean? So it's a blessing, man.
Yeah, so what I think, congratulations again, brother. What I think is only right is for you to give a story time. Let's say from the beginning of the seed with the first whips and first ever seeing the Rolls Royce and just that story,
right?
You know, what you was driving when you first ever seen the Rolls Royce and what made you, Rolls Royce Wraith, and what made you want to get that joint, because we're going to pick it up today.
Oh, yeah, for sure. I can just really break down, like, when I first got, like, a dope level car that I felt like I was that guy. And as you know, I know it's my, I had that CTS. Hopping out the coupe, you know what I'm saying? That
the red. Candy Apple Red.
Movie. Yeah, Candy Apple Red CTS coupe. It was crazy, you know what I'm saying? It kind of reminded me of a Wraith, how I first seen it. Like, that's a, you know what I'm saying, broke nigga Wraith type. It was different, it was bulky, but it was like, you know what I mean, innovative at the time. Had the dash that pops up, the, you know what I mean?
About a broke nigga Wraith, though. Man.
Yeah, I'm just saying.
Broke, like, nigga Wraith?
Yeah, the CTS.
You think so?
Yeah.
Broke nigga Wraith?
Yeah, what you think?
I don't know. I got to think about that one, though, brother.
Yeah, that's a bro. Nigga,
the screen did pop up.
Yeah, it was bulky but fast, but it looked different. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
It was like, never seen it before. Like,
right.
You know what I'm saying? So,
not so many people have, that's for sure. Definitely an electric joint.
Yeah, so
I think that was it. Was that a CTS?
Oh,
or
that was
ETS, or
that was ELC or some shit. I forgot.
ELC, yep.
That joint was hard, too.
That's what it was.
I wanted that, too. But the process of getting that was.
They didn't sell too
good. Yeah, they didn't say that. It was out in 1 year.
Come on, man.
The process of even getting that was crazy because I didn't have no license at the time. I didn't have no credit at the time. So, you know, the technique, of course, you get you a bitch, man. You sling that meat. You gonna get your treat, man. So I had to find a chick that was able to get in her name for me and all that. But how I even got that was a sneak move, because I needed a car at the time, because I had a car, my Lexus at the time. I was messing with this chick. It was in her name. I stopped fucking with her. She had a new boyfriend. He was jealous, like, can't get the car out my name and all that. No, matter of fact, I ain't getting out. You just take the car. You know what I'm saying?
Right.
You take the car, take the payments. I don't want that motherfucker no more. It's in your name anyway. How about that? Since you got a new man, see if he can afford it. Take this motherfucker back. You know what I'm saying? I don't want it no more. I ain't doing nothing. All right, well, here, take it back. So then I need a new car. Shit, now I ain't got no whip type. So, but I had, you know, extra girls on standby that's going to do that for me. So what happened? Go ahead.
I was just saying, is that when you seen the Rolls Royce? Was it that same year that you got that Cadillac?
Nah, hell no. Them ain't
when
come out.
When did the Rolls Royce Wraith come out?
I think 13.
13?
Yeah, so this is way before that.
Right.
You know what I'm saying? So,
because that's when I first came home.
Right.
No, actually, you had the Lexus when I first came home.
Yeah, when it came home, I had the Lexus. Yeah.
Green joint.
Yep, the GS 430. You know what I'm saying?
And then after that, then you got the CTS.
Yeah, so the GS 430 was the chunky one, too. I ain't gonna lie. That was, niggas ain't riding no Lexus at the time. That was a good car.
Right.
But for me to feel like super supreme and felt innovative and spaceship-ish was that CTS. Mm. Now, how I got her, I was telling her, boom, I need a new car, boo-boo, you know the technique, blah, blah, blah. But you gotta go in smooth. We just can't throw the cock in there. So I told her, like, listen up, baby. I need a new car. I ain't got no car. We get a regular car. Get me, like, a little Buick Regal, you know what I mean? A little $300 a month, boy. Fill out this application for that card. Boom, right?
Right.
So I'm like, boom. And I was like, yeah, just do that. So once she did that, boom, got approved. Me and my dog, Raw, was sitting there like looking at the cars at the place where my dog, Bino, worked at. Mm-hmm. We looking through the whips, like, oh, this is the Regal I'm going to get. He was like, then we was going through the cars. We saw that CTS. I'm like, oh, that's hard. He like, man, you got to get that. I'm like, shit, I don't know. That's like double the money. Now, my only told him, I need like a 25. This is like 50. I'm like, shit. But you already got approved for that. He's like, nigga, fuck that. Go get it. Tell them you want to do that one. See what they say. I'm like, you right. Fuck it. So I said, hey, Bino, go ahead and run that motherfucker for that GD. Like, man, it'll be more money. I said, go ahead, shit. He called me back like a day later, like, boom, you approve, you got it. I'm like, oh, shit. So mind you, I haven't told her this yet. She think I'm just getting that Regal. That's, you know what I'm saying, $25,000, not a car that's $50,000. So understand that. So, and it's the same money down, but the payment is double, you know what I'm saying? So like $600 a month. And I'll make that happen. Did I have the money in time? No, but I was gonna find it, get it done. I need that whip.
Right.
So boom. So like 2 days later, we go to the dealership. She picked me up. I'm going like, yeah, we don't get the car. Oh, I appreciate you. Thank you. Yeah, it ain't no problem. We get there, sit in the office, right? We sit in the office. You run the papers, throw me the papers, like boom. And she about to sign it. You know, I try to do it without even telling her. I'm gonna just sign the paper, but she ain't dumb. She looking like, this is more than it was. I'm like, oh yeah, this just, cause they had to add something to it. She like, I thought you said it was a Buick. I'm like, nah, it's actually this one. She was like, no, I don't want to do that. That's too much. I'm like, huh? And they understand you, it's an office full of people.
Rose.
What? I mean, it's just not me and him and her. It's three people over there trying to get cars. It's a full of people. And we just talking loud. I'm like, hey, let's go outside and talk. You like, you sure you want to go? Yeah, she like, I ain't doing it. He like, I'm like, yeah, let's go outside and talk. He like, yeah, y'all might want to go outside. So I took her outside, like, hey, listen up, baby. And this is the crazy thing about it too, because my brother was locked up and he ended up was cellies with a guy that knew Snoop, which is crazy. We're gonna get to Snoop later, but right. And he's like, yeah, he listened to your music and all that. And I was telling her that like a couple days before. So I used that in my brain. I was out there, listen up, baby. I'm about to get signed to Snoop. You wanna sign me? This ain't gonna be nothing. It's gonna be 1 year, I'll pay this off.
Right.
I just need that now. I can't be riding around no goddamn rig. I need this good car to look good. Boom, 1 year, I pay this motherfucker off. Snoop Dogg, but I don't need motherfucker Doghouse Records.
Right.
Let's do it. She like, no, I don't know. That's too much money. Can't put down my name. I said, listen up. If I can't pay it off in 1 year, then goddamn it, I don't know what I'm gonna do. Right. I'm gonna pay it off in a year. I probably ain't no other options. And she was like, it was like 20 minutes out there. Sweat is hot outside. I'm sweating. I'm like, I'm just looking at it. Come on, baby. Shit, you know what I'm saying? You know that little, the soft talk thing. Right. I'm just saying, man. Shit, you know what I mean? I'm going to get it, take care of it.
Got you, man.
Yeah, come on now. Trust me. Yeah, you know, then I'm going to give you some bread. And I'm going to get that deal tight. You know what I mean? All the finagle. 20 minutes out there in the baking sun and fine. She like, okay, I just get it. Quick, oh, got in there. I'm like, bam. He like, everything cool? I'm like, yeah. She signed that motherfucker. I couldn't believe it worked. Nigga, my heart beating out my chest. Understand, I got no whip at the time.
Right.
I can't be riding no damn
Trying
Buick.
Trying to save face at the same time.
Right, same face, because people in there. I can't be going from a Lexus to a Regal, Buick Regal. That's embarrassing. So, boom, she signed that motherfucker. I got that bitch. So, then I had the CTS coupe, and that shit was a banger. I felt like it was the Wraith. It felt the same when I had it. That motherfucker can tell me nothing, because where we from, niggas ain't around like that at the time.
Right.
You know what I mean? So, that was my first big legendary whip when I felt like how I feel today. The CTS coupe, man. Then I made a song, Hopping Out the Coupe, one of my biggest songs ever off that motherfucker. I never got signed to Snoop Dogg, though, but baby, you know what I'm saying? It's more to that story, too. I end up having to do a finagle move on her. I actually owe some bread. I got you, baby. Don't worry about it. I owe you.
Take
you
know care of her. Yeah. On the back way.
Yeah. Because I had to end up leaving, a little dry at the end,
Right.
Damn. I owe her that.
But look where you at now.
But look where I'm at now, man.
By the cop of Rolls Royce right today. And it's in your name.
Oh, everything in my name, man. That's a beautiful thing. About all the cars in my name.
The place.
Everything in my name. You know what I'm saying? And that's the blessing of the whole situation, that I did it the right way, not the wrong way. So worked hard, built that credit up. Worked hard, built my enterprise up.
Mm-hmm.
And so I can't wait just to walk in there and take care of that the real white man mode way. It was Rave Day.
Nothing better than that.
Oh, yeah, for sure.
And just to touch on that real quick, y'all, before we get into all the news and everything else that's going on in the world, shortcuts, man, don't take them. I know how appealing they may look.
Right.
But always take the long route. It's going to take longer for you to get there. Kind of like with us, what we did, right? We came in two real niggas in the game of YouTube. Nobody had ever done it before.
Right.
So it wasn't really socially accepted like that, right?
Mm-hmm.
But the thing is, we came in and we originated and we took a lot of backlash. We took a lot of goddamn motherfucking cuts and bruises and lumps along the way from, people trying to come in and discourage us to keep going on our journey.
That's a fact.
You know what I mean? And we made it easier for everybody. We blazed the path. So we took all the initial hits so everybody could come in behind behind us.
No question.
What I'm saying? That come from the same demographic in which we come from. You know what I'm saying? So that long route just feels so much more better and keeping it pure all the way along the way.
When you do it from the seed and you grow your own crops, so you see the ups and downs, whether you feel the droughts. You know what I'm saying? You see the locusts come and you fight them off. You know what I mean? You see the goddamn, you know, the farmers quitting on you and you just the one that's owning the whole goddamn land and you just got to keep harvesting your crops. And then when you get those fruit and you sell it off to the grocery store, you just going to enjoy it. Right. See your shit in Whole Foods. You know what I'm saying?
100%.
So yeah, we're going to Whole Foods today with this crop.
Put your own label on it.
Put your own label on it, man.
It's organic in the organic store.
Oh, from the seed, man. We got all type of shit. We got sanitizer. We got body wash. We got soap. And then ain't what you need, man. We got scout sauce, beer sauce. Nah, brother, more to come, too.
Right.
By the way. So it's a different feeling when you grow it from the seed, when you believe when nobody else believed, when you know what I'm saying? When you invest it when nobody else invested. It's a different type of texture that you walk around with, man. And different people see you in a different light. You got that glow when you do it right. And that's the way we did it.
And I always tell people there's no shortcuts in longevity. There's no shortcuts to it.
Nah.
You know what I'm saying? You got to just take that route. You know what I mean? You can't count the cost. Can't count the time.
Nah, you can't do that. That's something we live by, not counting time and not counting costs. We invest, we put it all in, and whatever come with it, come with it. But every time we did that, we came out on top. So
man, just make sure the passion there. Because you ain't going to make it far if it ain't.
Yeah, you got to make sure it's sturdy, man. You got to have that foundation right for sure.
1,000,000%.
You know what I mean? And try your best to do it the most right way. You know what I mean?
Right.
And it always pans out. Because you're going to need it to be right at the end. So try to do it right from the beginning.
100%.
Yeah.
Build that solid foundation.
Oh, for sure. It means
it counts.
A lot. Yeah,
it does. It's everything.
You build a house and you ain't got, you know what I'm saying? You ain't got your pillars right. You know what I'm saying? You build a house, you ain't check
Crumble.
If you buy a house, you ain't check for the termites. You know what I mean? That's a little ass bug, but it bring your whole shit down.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying?
They colonize.
Yeah, damn right. Goddamn reproduce all your shit. Goddamn asbestos all in the goddamn walls. Come on, man. Mold in the walls. You got to look at everything. So be cautious, but go hard regardless.
Yeah, and once you're there, so sustaining and maintaining is the most important piece.
You know what I'm saying?
Sustaining and maintaining the greatness that you've built and the foundation and the enterprise that you've built.
Oh, yeah, and then continue to goddamn reinvent, continue to reinvest, and continue to build on to what you already have. You know what I'm saying? You want to contain, maintain, and then continue to grow. It's very important.
Now, speaking of sustaining and maintaining, let's talk about these two NFL players that got accused of felony charges or whatever. They got charged with felony charges. I don't know if they got actually, they going to stick or not.
Yeah, they got arrested because I heard that, the witnesses type backing down.
Right.
You know what I'm saying? But they got arrested for, I guess it was gambling or something, right?
Right.
Gambling, lost their money. They got mad and doubled back and came back to go get that bag back from them. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah, so for anybody who don't know out there, there's a lot of NFL, a lot of NBA niggas that got hood ties or either hood niggas that got lucky and made it out.
Oh, for sure.
You know what I'm saying? So a lot of times what happens is they get that money and they go back to the same environments in which they came from, which is a no-no. You know what I'm saying? Definitely if you're going back there, because you got to understand, I don't know if they was gambling with niggas with likewise money. You know, but the thing is, though, ain't nothing worse. You know, because if I believe so correctly, Lil Snoop was gambling on a game, a RP
game.
Lil Snoop.
Yep.
You know what I'm saying? And you a rich nigga compared to the nigga you was playing and betting on the video game. And the hood, you know, the hood rules ain't got to pay up, champ.
Right.
You know what I'm saying? And if Lil Snoop, some niggas can't take that losing to a rich nigga.
Right.
You know what I'm saying?
At all. You can't take a no from a rich nigga either.
Exactly. Or if a rich nigga standing on something.
Right.
Because there's already something boiling in the heart and the jealousy, hate, and envy boiling within them. You know what I'm saying?
No question.
So if you win and you type maybe talking greasy or something, that's all the reason they need to really type smoking, nigga.
Oh,
you know
yeah,
what
for
saying?
Sure. They can't wait to do that.
And that's some whole ass shit to do, but you know, motherfuckers do it all the time and we see it all the time. But those two NFL niggas from what we seeing, he was playing a dice game, right?
Right. Big dice game.
Right.
Play the dice game, they end up, I think they lost their money. And, and I guess the guy wanted to walk off with the money. You know what I'm saying?
No, where you going with that bread?
Yeah, no, you got to play to the end. Like, he got up, and they're like, no, we're going to go to, there's nothing left. And dude like, no, I'm cool already, man. I done got all y'all bread. I'm about here, man.
Right.
And they wasn't going. And they, you know what I'm saying, try to rob him, take it back tight.
So let me tell y'all
about
that.
It happens all the time.
Yeah, now let's just equate it to all the hood niggas out there in the world. If you shooting dice in the hood, right? Bang, you hitting him upside the head. And then next thing you know, the nigga went all his money back.
Right.
And then don't give you a chance to get your... Then he gonna be like, nah, hell no, what you doing? You can't take the bread. Nah. You see what I'm saying?
Because
everybody
know
you quit on the dice. But
right.
The thing is, the rules is, if I remember correctly from shooting dice, my little brother DJ was the coach, nigga, at Officer Jones. Go subscribe.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? He, a lot of times motherfuckers get hot. You know what I'm saying? And the next thing you know, they get their money. You're supposed to quit on your dice, correct?
Right, on your dice.
But niggas in the hood don't
ain't gonna let it go.
Come on, man.
They won't let it go. You can't win all the money. and then run off. Even if, like, okay, say it's like 50,000 on the table, and I'm saying you get the 50, but he got like a probably extra 10 in his pocket. You done got right. 50 up off him, and you trying to run off with that 50. No, I got another 10 and still go, bro. We got to go till I'm broke. And that's just an unwritten hood rule that motherfuckers going to about kill you about. You know what right. I mean? Or turn around and rob the whole place about. So you got to play to the end. That's why I don't gamble, man. Don't gamble, people, man. Yeah. Especially no hood gambling. That shit costs you your life and a lot of money, man.
Yeah, I learned a gambling lesson real early in life, boy.
There's another story.
My brother DJ. I'll tell that story later, though.
Yeah, hold that one. Also, this talking about an NFL player that's crazy with it. You remember Chris Johnson? You know what I'm saying? He got shot last year. I think like a year or two ago.
I don't remember. I pulled him up.
He got shot, and then his homeboy got killed. And then, like, recently they're trying to, like, get him arrested because the dudes that shot him and killed his homeboy, they got whacked. And they trying to say he lined them up, got paid to pay the motherfucking streets, put that price on the niggas' head, got them whacked up out of there. So they trying to double back and said that he did that, you know what I'm saying? Which is crazy.
Oh, I do think I seen this.
Yeah. He got shot in his arm, and one of his homeboys got killed, but he put that bag up on them niggas, got them smoked, nigga. And then the niggas that smoked him, I think they ratted on him. And he, like, not only did he give him a bag for smoking, like, in the hood, or whatever organization they were, the streets it was in, he, like, got them moved up in the drug game, too, out there or something.
Right.
Top level nigga, man. Some niggas ain't to be played with. That's because they play sports, man. Like, Pac-Man Jones ain't a person to play with, man. Some niggas is different, man. Don't get that sports and all that shit fucked up. You know what I mean? So
yeah, big balloon.
But I don't think he got arrested. I think they're trying to accuse him and try to set it up. I don't think they got enough evidence to get him, man. So shout out to Chris Johnson, man. I understand it, brother. I don't condone violence.
Right.
But if a nigga shoot me, kill my friend, they come up dead, hey, brother, I wouldn't be mad at it.
God bless you.
Straight up.
But the thing, 2,000-yard season after they got shot, too.
Hey, BG, right. For some reason, this mic is real low, champ. I don't know what's going on with it. Hey, they're better. There you go. Yeah, but no, what I was going to say, too, is one thing I don't like, though, and to double on the condoning, what you said, one thing I don't like, bro, is niggas that get money and don't know how to flip the script. Like, you got to learn how to, like, you can be yourself, but the delivery of being yourself must change. It has to change.
It has to change. You got to evolve. You know, I know it's in you, but you have to evolve. You got to be smart, and you got so many people depend on you, and you got it the right way.
Right.
That's what people dream of. Even people in the streets love to find a way to get out that shit and do it the right way. You know what I'm saying?
Sustain and maintain. Man.
Right, so if you got an opportunity to do it the right way, do it, man. Fight.
Because if you don't, what's going to happen? Like, because if I never change, people going to be like, oh, man, you changed. If I never change, I wouldn't be where I'm at right now today.
Right.
You know what I'm saying? So change is absolutely mandatory.
Extremely
important. To sustain and maintain what you've had and what you've been able to accomplish and what you're trying to get to in life. You got to consistently make changes and consistently know that your way isn't always the best way.
Right.
You know what I'm saying? Like, and I'm a person that likes it my way all the goddamn time.
Oh, for sure.
You are too, nigga.
Oh,
you
know what I'm saying? About it.
But the thing is, though, we have to take criticism and we have to be able to add to the arsenal, you know what I'm saying, of changes within ourselves, on the exterior, how we conduct business, how we think. That's the hardest thing. Changing how you think is one of the hardest things in the world.
And your instant, like, reactions and stuff like that. That's the hardest thing to, like, transform, because you know you built a certain way for so long. Something said to you or something goes on, your instant reaction is like, boom. But you got to kind of control that.
Like Nipsey said, he said the same thing. We got to change when we disrespected, how we go about handling feeling disrespected.
Right.
Because
you got too much to lose. You got too much to lose and so much to gain. So you got to know when to walk away. You got to know when to accept. Sometimes, like I said, you could be called a bitch or you be called dead.
Which one?
You be called a bitch or you could be called inmate.
Right.
You know what I'm saying? Which one you want. So
is it really that serious, man?
And it's really that serious, man.
And it's really just within the black community, because white people, they go through it all the time.
Yeah, they don't got them issues like that. Fuck no.
Ain't that crazy?
Yeah.
But black people would die by that respect.
Oh, for sure. Instantly, too.
But be broke.
Oh, yeah.
Ain't that crazy? I know from
rich,
that's how I was.
Rich in respect and broken goddamn revenue. It's a shame.
You got, exactly. That's exactly. I couldn't say it any better, brother. That's 100% right.
Motherfuckers rather be rich in respect.
Yeah, we got to change that, man.
Oh, for sure.
You know what I'm saying? Because that's just not worth it. Definitely when you get into the money, if you can make it out of it, because you already statistically are an anomaly.
Right.
If you get up out of there,
you already cracked the code.
Yeah, so change the blueprint and help other people out of there. Like what LeBron does.
Right.
He doesn't just give motherfuckers money, he teaches motherfuckers blueprints on how to go about things. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
And speaking of LeBron, shout out to motherfucking Michael Jordan, black, bald ass.
For sure.
Because, boy,
savage.
Listen here, man.
Crazy.
Damn.
Different dude, man.
I ain't never watched that much of Jordan in my life.
But because you was out your era, you know what I'm saying?
No, it was in my era. But it was. I didn't watch basketball
sports,
growing
up. I'm saying, yeah, you didn't watch the sport. Right. You didn't watch it at the time. But when you go back and look at it, it's a, man, he's the god of the game, man.
Yeah.
Point blank, period. He's the Jesus of the basketball, bro.
I ain't going to hold you. But this is one thing I've always said, though. The thing is, people are always tagging me in something about, like, man, Michael Jordan, go with the basketball.
They know you about that, yeah.
But the thing is, though, I never said basketball, right, skill set wise, he wasn't.
Right.
Go back and listen to all the goddamn podcasts.
Yeah, you're talking about personally.
Basketball set wise, listen here, nigga.
Lord.
But even before watching this whole Last Dance thing,
right,
I believed it.
Right.
You know what I'm saying? But the thing is, though, me as a person, I got to go with the universalness.
Right.
You know what I'm saying? But on some basketball shit, I've always said it. Who cares? You know what I mean?
Right.
But I'm always thinking bigger than
the
basketball.
Overall, yeah.
Yeah, like LeBron said, more than the athlete, man.
Yeah, shout out to LeBron,
BG,
man.
My mic went down again. It didn't? No, it seemed like it went, there it goes, it's better now. But the thing is, though, is it's been no comparison with that.
Right.
You know what I'm saying?
Yeah,
like, come on, man.
Because you just watch, like I said, you just watch how you're on the court, how people respect him and talk to him, how his teammates, like, they ain't going to talk about him like,
yeah,
they ain't going to talk about LeBron like that. It ain't going to be that. It ain't going to be that when he gone. You know what I'm saying? Because it's just a different level of purity within this guy. You know what I'm saying? He's undiluted greatness, undiluted motherfucking ferociousness, undiluted victories.
Yeah.
He's not playing about nothing.
Yeah.
40, 30 years later, nigga, he hate them niggas.
Yeah.
What? Don't play with me. Who? Gary Payton? The glove?
Laughed at him.
What? I won't worry about him.
Who? Gary Payton? Worry about the glove.
Come on.
You could tell that lad was authentic.
Nigga, Clyde Drexler, come get this smoke. He compared to me.
Let me go ahead and just tell y'all we ain't on the same level.
And this, nigga, he,
go ahead, brother.
This is Michael Jordan today talking like that.
Mm-hmm.
So how was he feeling then, sitting in that locker room with that ball head sweating, ready to get in that game? Nigga, he coming to kill some shit and 100%. Whatever came with it. Like I said, LeBron, legendary nigga. But that shit inside that ball, black nigga right there,
no,
it's only one.
No comparison.
And Kobe had a little drip of that, but he ain't, this is pure undiluted.
Wasn't the originator.
No.
Right.
This nigga had the black plague in
Kobe.
Him. That nigga had the black plague in him with this motherfucking victory, nigga. Whatever came with it.
Right.
Whatever he did.
100%.
He wasn't playing, man.
But the thing for me, though, is the best thing that I like about Michael Jordan isn't the shoes. It isn't the championships. The best thing I like about Michael Jordan is that mentality.
That's the craziest of all time.
Because I'm going to tell you, he want to die by everything, and he full troll brain.
And it's to the end. It's to the death.
Brain.
It's to the death. He see everything.
1 billion percent.
Hate you to the death, to this day.
100%.
He gonna never, my nigga Deontay Wilder, to this day, he gonna hate you to the death, and he ain't playing.
Right.
And he don't forget nothing.
Facts. Don't ever do that. You know what I'm saying? And the thing is, he makes stuff out of the air just to have more fuel.
Yep.
You know what I'm saying? That's a motherfucker that's not to be fucked with. But the thing is, though, the biggest thing about that mentality, though, that was the dopest shit to me, is the biggest thing that stuck with me out that whole Last Dance documentary is when he said, achieving greatness, it comes at a price.
Oh, for
and
sure.
And it does.
It does.
People ain't going to like it.
No, it does.
Some ain't going to hate. Some going to hate you.
The greatest people are not the most loved.
Some people going to dislike you. Some people going to hate you. Exactly. But to really achieve pure greatness and success, you got to be an unlikable motherfucker at times because you got to do the shit that nobody else wants to do.
Yep.
And one thing I agree with, get motherfuckers up out of there, man. Hey, man, you ain't playing right. Get your ass traded, man.
Get going.
Or, yeah. Anything. Hey, man, you ain't going to win this shit with the GM, but he going to stand on it. Hey, man, I'll retire. Fuck that and
he
fuck
stood
you.
On it. He died about
fuck
it.
Fuck that and fuck you.
He was at his prime. He said, I played the best. I was in the best shape. I was mastering the game even better because I used my mind
more
than my body.
He said that last one was better than anything else.
Right. He said, I was using my mind more than my body, so it was actually easier because I know a little more nicks and crannies.
Before, I was just wild man with skill.
It's just pure athleticism over everybody. Now I'm using my skull.
Mm-hmm.
And I had to tap out because, nigga, I stood on it.
Yep.
I stood on it. I died about it.
So I respect that, though.
Yeah, and then he's so mastermind about it because he went to the Wizards, of course. You know, that's not even on there, but he went there.
I want them to put that in there.
I know, because that's a whole other part, because you understand.
But you want to leave that legacy untainted because that was a, come on, man. But he still came back and killed.
Because he went there, got some ownership, and then went and owned his own entire team. What other motherfucking player owns the entire team? Majority. Magic got a little bit of little tiny percentage. He's full majority owner.
Right.
Of the Bobcats.
No, for sure.
Come on, man.
But you know, one thing I can understand is how he is a majority owner of the Bobcats, but still only worth $3 billion. Because that team got to be worth at least somewhere around there, right? Not maybe $3 billion, but maybe $1 billion at least.
Yeah, he's worth 2.1, but he's majority owner. So it's, other people got percentages.
Right.
You know what I'm saying? So, yeah.
Right. Okay.
He's worth $2.1 billion. But no, that team ain't worth no billions.
It got to be at least worth $1 billion. I don't think there's one team in the NBA that's worth less than $1 billion, bro.
I don't know.
You know what I'm saying?
I don't know, because
can we Clippers, pull that up?
The Clippers
and
was
see
the highest,
what's the cheapest team in the NBA.
The Clippers was the highest sold team, nigga, like $2 billion or some shit like that. And then like when Mark Cuban first bought the Mavs, they were like $500 million or something.
$2 billion?
Yeah. And now they worth a goddamn like $5 billion.
We got
shit.
To pull that
know.
Up, brother.
Yeah, how much did Michael Jordan buy the Bobcats for?
I'm not gonna lie though. Michael Jordan's mentality bar, I ain't gonna hold you like that. That's like it's never been done before. You know what I'm saying?
The,
and he looked at everybody with a vindictive, personality. I'm going for everybody's head, guillotine. And I'm not gonna lie, LeBron ain't got that.
See, look, the Knicks.
But LeBron got that in a different type of light. You know what I'm saying?
See, the Knicks is worth $4.6 billion. See what I'm saying?
Knicks and Lakers are always worth the most in the Warriors, right?
No.
Now, but it was. It used to be. I think it used to be Lakers, Bulls, and Knicks was always the highest teams.
Knicks at 4.6, Lakers at 4.4, Warriors at 4.4.
So let's look up the Bobcats real quick. Look up, see how much that team is worth.
No, the Charlotte Hornets. That's what it is.
Yeah, Charlotte Hornets. Yeah.
I forgot they didn't change. I'm tripping.
No, but Charlotte, it's not Charlotte Hornets. Did they change it back to Charlotte Hornets?
Yeah, Charlotte Hornets again.
Yeah, man. See, yeah, they keep changing shit. Right. I like Charlotte Hornets better than
that's
the Bobcats.
My nigga Larry Johnson.
And their logo was dope, too.
Oh, super hard. Them one jersey was cold. Kevin, Larry Johnson got that Muggsy Bowles type.
Yeah, facts.
Let me see, man.
But that's crazy, though, bro. Like, I ain't gonna lie. But the thing is, I believe LeBron James has 1. That.
1.5 million.
I told you.
1,500 million.
Yeah, so that's 1,500 million.
Can you look
million.
Up the cheapest team in the NBA? I don't want to see what's like.
Worth?
I'm telling you, bro, I don't think there's not one team worth less than a billion. You got to be a billionaire to own a team. You know what I'm saying?
A billion?
You got to be a billionaire to own an NBA team, NFL team, or any of that kind of shit. You know what I'm saying?
Right.
I believe so. But the crazy part is, though, bro, I do believe LeBron has that mentality in a different aspect of basketball. You know what I'm saying? It's not taking the last shot sometimes, but he has done it. But you know what I mean? And statistically, if I'm not wrong, people are going to try to say, but we can pull this up. I think LeBron James has hit more game-winning fourth quarter shots than Michael Jordan.
I mean, probably because
I believe that's a fact, brother.
But
I've seen that
just a different texture of the shots that Jordan took. You know what I'm saying?
No question.
Because LeBron is more of a team facilitator. You know what I'm saying?
For sure.
And so he passed the ball most of the time. You know what I'm saying? And you can't fault
Michael
for that.
Michael Jordan has done it too sometimes.
Yeah, and it won. You know what I'm saying?
Right.
But it's just the ones that Jordan hit was just so phenomenal. You know what I'm saying?
Memphis Grizzlies is worth how much?
1.3, I guess.
Billion.
The same.
Yeah, 1.3 billion.
See what I'm saying? There's not one team less than a billion, brother.
Yeah, for sure. I'm talking about back in the day when they bought them, though, it was cheaper. You know what I'm saying?
Oh, yeah, that's prehistoric dinosaur ages, though, brother.
I don't know.
They're right behind the Cavs.
It might have still been some billions back then, though, brother.
Nah, I think I told you Mark Cuban. How much? Can you put up how much Mark Cuban bought the Mavs for? Because they up there now because he won that championship.
Right, yeah.
He bought them for the low, though.
I did a video. Shout out to Cron Butler. I did a video with him. When they won that, because you know he was with Dirk Nowitzki when they won that.
He bought it. There you go. Nigga, come on, man. Nigga, don't play with me,
bro. Bought it for $285 million. You right.
Yep. Yep.
That was billions in 2000.
The Mavericks won only four. Yep. That was when? 2000.
Yeah.
Ain't that 20 years ago.
Yeah, for
still
sure.
Still in the 2000s, though. So look, 285. You see what I'm saying? So now it's worth, they invested in that shit. Now,
but back then, there was, if you're going off the dollar based off, like, that was like a billion back
then.
And
when did Jordan buy this, the Bobcats?
Based off the economy then?
It's probably a little bit around that time, not too far off. You know what I'm saying?
Right. You think so?
Yeah.
2010.
He became controlled, yep, from Rob Johnson.
But 2006,
yep. He invested in full ownership.
Yep, he took it, he invested and then bought it fully in 2010.
But he invested in 2006.
Yep.
And took over in 2010.
Come on now.
Yeah.
He owned a team. That's crazy.
But LeBron going to do that too, though.
I think so.
I believe
his business acumen is legendary, you know what I'm saying? Yeah. And that's what I like about all of them. You know what I'm saying? I like all of them that's on that business mind, that's independent and growing different companies. And if I'm a partner with a company, I need some ownership in it.
Yeah, look, Jordan hit 8 of 16 clutch attempts and just one more than LeBron.
Right.
Okay, so that gives him a 50% ratio to LeBron's 43.8.
Which is still great.
One shot really isn't that much of a difference. Okay, so I don't know, though, brother. I thought I saw something on ESPN that said LeBron.
Nah, there you go. They said it right there, man. Come
more
on now.
Shots. LeBron James has also hit more buzzer beaters than Jordan. Yes, I was right.
Buzzer beaters, but we talking about the main one is up there, though.
And more go-ahead shots with 5 seconds to go in the game. His field goal percentage on these shots is also higher than Jordan's. But I'm not going to lie.
Let me keep it pure, though. Okay.
The impact, like, you know what I'm saying? Like, man, Jordan is fucking phenomenal.
He's the NBA.
Brother.
Jordan made the NBA, bro. Because it was
why they got
novelty.
Jerry West as the logo, though?
I know.
It should be a black nigga on there, man.
Yeah, they tripping.
It should either be LeBron or Michael Jordan, man.
No, it should be Kobe, though. It should be Kobe.
No, I ain't going to lie. When they said Kobe at first,
it should be Kobe.
I said it should have been Kobe.
Yeah.
When they first said that,
it should be Kobe.
Why didn't they change Jerry West? Get his ass off there, man.
It should be Kobe. Can't do Jordan because Jordan, the Jumpman.
Is Jerry West the logo?
You know the dude was suing about that Jumpman logo trying to get billions. He just lost it.
I heard about that.
Yeah, he was trying to. Lucky Nike too big. They got him because they switched the outfits.
Right.
And that's why he didn't get his money.
But that was his shit, though.
That was, he took the picture when he was in college. And then they did another one later on when he was in the NBA, but they changed the outfit, changed the background.
Damn,
and
they bogus, though.
And that's why he didn't get the money for it. He tried to get it.
They should have gave him to because the concept's still the same.
Yeah, no question. But they got too much money. They probably paid the back doors.
They went all to the Supreme Court.
Yeah, that's crazy, right?
Yeah, hell
that
yeah.
Nigga tried to hit a lick of the
city. They should have gave him at least a billion or something. Come on, man. Give him something. Y'all know y'all took his shit.
Something, God.
Give him some pennies off that motherfucker, man.
They probably offered him something like, here, 100 million. No, I want the most, see?
Yep. Just took it.
Yep, and he fought it.
But I respect for standing on it, though.
Hey, it go both ways.
But you got to know you ain't beat Nike champ.
Come on, champion.
You know what I'm saying?
What do you think LeBron tries to buy when he goes back?
You said what?
What team do you think LeBron would end up trying to buy when he's creating?
The Cavs?
Cavs. You know what I'm saying? But the thing, he ain't getting that off Dan Gilbert.
Oh, he hates.
You know what I'm saying? Dan Gilbert hates LeBron.
That one coach was real supposed in his damn life, huh? Jordan way better than LeBron and the team player. Made nobody better. Same shit I've been saying, but, you know, he was there. He was his coach.
But at the same time, though, bro, I think people mentally was just tougher back then, too, so he could take what LeBron was scolding. Like, who's to say LeBron ain't doing the same thing? But the thing is, though, bro, I'm just keep it pure. And I will say, I'm going to keep it real with you on this one, man. Here's one point where you got me, though. That nigga did groom Scotty, brother.
I told you, but it's all right. It's all right, brother.
Yeah, he did.
We grew
up together.
But
he was still fifth pick first round.
That's the part I fucked up on. And so, I always stood on it the years. I'm like, oh, shit. But he groomed that nigga, and you could tell after it wasn't the same. Like,
but
you know
the thing is, he didn't really groom. He just scolded that nigga.
I know. He
scolded him.
Gave him that understanding.
And then hazed him.
Right.
And that's what made him activate.
Right.
But people, I think LeBron could do the same thing. I think he'd be on people's ass like that. But
he ain't got it like that.
No, it's not even that he ain't got it like that. I think nobody has it like Scotty had it. You know what I'm saying? On some pure shit. Because think about it, man. Kyrie gave up, man. You
soft.
Know what I'm saying? You don't think? Come on, man.
Soft.
Come on, brother.
But you know he got to know how to.
And I fuck with Kyrie, but
he ain't
LeBron's
got
a perfectionist, madman brain. He might not come across like pure dickhead
but
asshole.
But
just like Jordan.
Door, he gonna stand on him.
Come on, man. That's what I'm saying.
Nigga, I need this, nigga. This my team.
Niggas, and Kyrie was like, he wanted to be that nigga.
Right.
You not bigger than LeBron,
left.
Bro.
Nigga left.
That's what I'm saying.
Whole ass nigga, man.
Come on, bro.
Athletes won a championship.
So he had the. Kyrie Irving had the skill set by far, bar none. One of the best point guards ever played
right.
the game. And he don't, that mentality in that
nigga
heart.
Talking
like
about
you
the earth was flat. Get his goof ass up out
here. Come
nigga,
on, man. Somebody said
that
in the comments. Man, just let me think the earth flat. Right, get the fuck out of here, man.
He ain't that, man.
But that's what I'm saying.
And it just, and then, like I said, and
when Michael came at Scotty, he stepped it up mentally on an elevation game. Kyrie couldn't do that with LeBron.
And Joe, like I told you, that nigga makes everybody understand what the fuck going on.
Scott Burrell, my team. Get Kirk, in order.
Nigga, he in practice. Nigga, coaching. You seen him? Watching them niggas.
Yeah.
Nigga,
and see, that's what I'm saying.
LeBron ain't doing that. He's different.
But this is a different era, though, too.
That's true.
You know what I mean?
Everybody for self.
This is a different era.
Everybody for
self. You know what I mean? Back then, people knew there's that nigga, and then there's everybody else.
For sure.
Kyrie couldn't bow out to LeBron being that nigga.
He won't be Instagram and be goddamn what's the old.
I hit the, because this is what the equipment.
Because they talking about the game winner, the best shot ever type nigga. Shut up, nigga.
Come on, and then he believed his own gas.
Right.
You know what I'm saying?
Nigga, this is my team. Get your goof ass out of here.
I passed you the ball just like Jordan passed it to Paxton, and he knocked it down.
Right.
Just like he passed it to Steve Curry, he knocked
it
down.
Kept passing it to him, yeah.
Come on, brother. You way better than Steve Curry and Paxton.
Right.
But the thing is, though, bro.
They played their role.
They played their role.
And look at them rings, nigga.
And Scotty was number two. Scotty, you don't think Scotty wanted to be number one?
Of course. You saw it because he didn't. You said the cool coach, he didn't want to come out, did he? Didn't he sell out? Didn't he want that game winner?
Look at the pinky, man.
Cool coach was six. Nigga made six in a row. Nigga, he finna shoot the shot. Nigga got mad. Trying to say, you're not Jordan, Pippen. You bitch. Sit your monkey ass.
I ain't going to lie. They wrong for not letting Pippen shoot that shot, though.
But who hit it, though?
He hit it.
Cool coach was that nigga. He always was jealous of cool coach.
Think so?
Yeah, he hated him.
Yeah, from when they first played, he said.
Kukoc is the, if you don't know about Kukoc, internationally, he was one of the most.
That nigga.
In the history books.
So it's like equivalent to, what's the old boy for Dallas?
Nowitzki.
Nowitzki.
No, the young dude.
Come on, the new nigga.
Nicole, yeah.
I forget his name.
Me too, he wrong.
What the fuck is his name?
Drazic, what's his name?
Damn, I forget his name. Yeah, he cold, though. He top level. Even LeBron acknowledged, like, that nigga.
Yeah, and it was another, no, who was cold like that, too, overseas and got here late and still was killing?
Who?
That nigga, Avinash Sabonis. Remember Sabonis?
Oh, yeah, killing.
He came here as an old man giving Shaq and them niggas work.
You know who else did that, too?
Who?
And was killing? Old boy with the Kings.
Oh, Vlade Divac.
Come on, man.
And you ever heard of Drazen Petrovic?
No.
That nigga that died, nigga, look him up.
That's type back in the day.
No,
he wasn't watching that.
He died in a car accident. That nigga was a cold nigga. Drazen Petrovic, he came with Vlade Divac. He died in a car accident, though.
Oh, damn.
Sharp shooter, nigga. Cold-blooded nigga. Niggas know about Drazen Petrovic, nigga. If y'all know basketball, comment below, let me know. That was that dude,
yeah,
boy.
Yeah, no, that's crazy.
Some of them dudes was already substantial where they was at. They came here late and still was killing. Yeah. Like, Sabinas came as an old man and got rookie of the year giving niggas numbers.
Luka
Doncic.
Luka Cole.
Yeah, come on, man.
Luka Cole.
That's what I'm saying. That's
Porzingis is on that team, too, but Luka.
Porzingis didn't type.
Yeah, he type fell off, but yeah. Luka raw. And then who else was that that came late that was killing type? Even how Yamin came.
Yep.
Like, man, that was because of Jordan and them niggas that Dream Team brought an international. They changed the – man, listen, brother. Michael Jordan,
but
man.
It has to go. Jerry Krause was a bitch ass nigga.
Oh, but, man, the thing, but he was the coldest GM ever.
Cold, I ain't gonna lie, to line that Master shit up.
Because he was picking the niggas. Mm-hmm. Only one he didn't pick was Jordan, though.
I ain't gonna lie, I wouldn't give him the coldest GM. I got to give that to Jerry West, brother. Because he didn't line up some shit. I got to give it to Jerry West,
but
brother.
But he got the coldest dynasties, though. He got three. He got two three-peats.
That's true, you right.
And he picked
He did, though. He gets that.
Nigga
picked Jerry West,
because you got to give him. He picked Scotty, bro.
He did pick Scotty.
And Coach.
Can we double back on the Scotty, though, brother? How he stepped up to, I'm the second best.
And accepted.
How Kyrie couldn't do that with LeBron.
Yep.
Because if Kyrie would have did that with LeBron, bro.
Been winning.
Come on, man.
Niggas is dumb, man.
The fuck?
Like, dude, Dwayne Wade, he was that nigga.
And he took a backseat to LeBron.
LeBron was trying to give it to him. He said, no.
It's your show.
It's okay.
Go crazy.
Shout out to Dwayne Wade for that.
And Chris Bosh, because Chris Bosh took a big backseat, too.
It's your
team.
Third
wheel to the moon.
And they was like,
and Chris Bosh was
Who else couldn't do that?
What you mean?
Who else couldn't play their role? Even though you that nigga, but you had to step back a little bit because it ain't yours, nigga. Tarantula, nigga.
Who are you going to take a backseat to who?
To Steph Curry. This ain't your team.
Man, he's better than Steph Curry, though.
That's why he off the team. He fucked it up. See?
No, they got rid of him. They offered him the Supermax.
I understand. He got rid of himself. Kyrie got rid of himself.
Any team KD go to, brother, he number one, nigga. Sorry.
So that's why they lost, man. He couldn't play his role.
He was number one on the team.
He was mad the whole time. He was number one, but he supposed to stay back a little bit.
Yes, it's Steph's team.
Right.
But the thing is, he number one talent. He's the Jordan on that team.
So you don't think he should have just calmed down a little bit and let them their chemistry ride? He just played the back row a little bit?
1,000,000,000%.
And that's why he broke it up. They supposed to win five championships in a row, man.
They should have. They should have had the most in NBA
Nigga
history.
Nigga left, man.
They should have had the most in NBA history.
Nigga left, man. How you lead the Warriors, man? Is you kidding me, man?
You already committed. You
that's
should.
Personal, brother. Nothing to do with basketball.
We don't know the behind the scenes,
That's
though.
What I'm saying, though. It's personal.
Yeah.
You didn't want to win with them. You despised them because you didn't want to play your role, bro. Now you're going to be a loser with another loser nigga forever.
You think they're going to win?
Man, hell no. Them niggas is out of there, man. Niggas is embarrassed.
I ain't going to lie. That's why I say, like.
Didn't he have Corona?
He did have Corona.
Good. No, I'm sorry.
Yeah. But no, last thing I got to say about that, though, brother. LeBron, as far as the mentality, I do believe he has the Jordan just in a different aspect, and he's in a much nicer guy way with it.
Right.
One thing I respect about Jordan, he, I ain't gonna lie, man, you gotta come at a motherfucker verbally sometimes, like, and it might not be the most likable shit, but I'm gonna keep it pure with you. Here's what you is, you fucking suck today.
Right.
You're a bum.
Right.
Don't mean you're gonna be that way the next game, but here you go, I gotta light that fire into your ass. And if you can't stand the heat, get the fuck out the kitchen.
And he ain't playing.
Good call.
And see, the difference with Jordan, too, is he was with the ass. He was whooping niggas, fighting niggas. He was with that.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? He was with that. He grabbed Reggie Miller by his goddamn
he
neck.
He wasn't
nigga,
playing.
Slapped Steve Kerr in the mouth. He with all that shit now. Jordan was on it, man.
Yeah.
He wasn't playing.
And the biggest thing that I've seen from The Last Dance now that I got from Jordan that I never knew about him is I never really knew him internally. Like I still don't know him internally. Nobody does. You know what I'm saying?
Never gonna give you all that.
It's an edited move.
He gonna give you all that.
But the thing is, though, is I feel like he came from a good intention spot with all of them. Like,
because
for him to be that emotional, he definitely cares more than people know.
It's pure from him. It's coming straight from the heart. And he ain't playing.
He wears his heart on his sleeves.
Yes, because he
can always respect a nigga like that.
Because he's giving it his all every time. Mm-hmm. So I need that from you. If you don't get that to me, nigga, fuck you. Because I'm giving you everything, nigga. Every second. You hear me? So if you ain't going to do that, man, you got to go.
Because right.
I'm going to die about it.
Yeah.
And nigga, you going to see. That's why he was like, nigga, I'm giving everything, nigga. I ain't ask you nothing that I ain't going to do, nigga. And he start crying because, nigga, how dare you play with me, nigga?
Yeah.
I'm giving it all.
I care that much.
Man, what?
And the thing is, I can't say I don't respect Jordan or I don't believe that he's that top level nigga because I operate like that every day.
Most definitely.
You know what I'm saying? So for me to not rock with that, that would be kind of contradicting because that's exactly how I am as far as how I look at things. If you give somebody your all, I expect the all back.
Right. It's only
otherwise,
right.
Otherwise, fuck you, and it's fuck right. you till the end of time.
Oh yeah,
you
know for sure. And only a certain people could understand that. You know what I'm saying?
Right. Even and like, that's why me and you get along so well because right. we've had, you know what I'm saying?
Oh, for sure.
We talking about, and I've used different situations with people, and you've seen firsthand that I'm like that with people. I give my all to us. If I fuck with you,
it's everything.
I die and go to the end with you.
Oh, for sure.
But if I feel like I don't get that back, reciprocation is a big thing, man.
Oh yeah, it's pure fuck you, and there ain't no in betweens with Slim. You know what I'm saying? Mm-hmm. And I'm a person that I never give people my all like that, nigga, because the shit in my past, niggas play, and I just don't know how to do that. But once I relinquish that to certain people, I see the growth in it. I see the positive outcome of it. Then you got such an extra goddamn cloak around you because you know somebody don't go for you like you don't go for them. It ain't no questioning. It ain't no slowing down. It's full speed ahead, nigga. It's full understanding. And it's a different type of texture when you got that. You know what I'm saying? And it's rare you gonna got people that's gonna do that with you. Right. You know what I'm saying? So that's why how you see me and Slim move like that, because we got that. We got that immortal goddamn whatever it takes. You shine, I shine. I get a race. Right. He get a Lambo. We happy. He's smiling. Like I said, the best explanation of our relationship is we was playing at Venice Beach, nigga, and I go through the lane, duck on them niggas, boom, I'm hanging upside backwards. I can't even see this nigga. This nigga at half court smiling bigger than me. That's
how you do it. I didn't even look back at you. I knew what you did.
Yeah. I said, give me the ball for duck on these niggas. Ah, boom, nigga that's smiling. That's the nigga that's clapping for you when you can't see him. Yep. Not the nigga that's looking at you winning and be like, the nigga that's clapping loud, screaming for you, and do that for them. It's a different type of texture,
it's
man.
A different type of understanding.
Everybody ain't got that, man.
No.
Straight up.
You know what I mean? So it's a good thing to have people. So make sure you keep that in mind as you're going about your business.
Oh, yeah,
you know
for sure. And make sure you be mindful of who you get at, too, man. Like I said, who you call your dog may pay attention to that, because the dog gonna love you as much as they love themselves or even more.
Yeah, you see that.
Everybody
on
ain't
IG.
Your motherfucking dog, man.
Follow us both on IG.
That's my
Mr.
motherfucking
Organic,
dog right there.
You my dog, brother.
For sure.
And the love is always reciprocated. You know what I'm saying?
Oh, man, for sure, for sure.
Yeah, you gotta have understanding with your people. You know what I mean? And the thing is, too, one thing I want to touch on, the last thing I'm going to touch on with Last Dance, is, and this is one thing I feel about with you as far as our YouTube journey and everything we've done. Michael Jordan said, every time you talk about me, you got to talk about Scottie.
No question.
So anytime somebody talk about me, I feel like they got to talk about
you. Even though we don't like the Scottie and Pippen, because that make one nigga Batman and Robin type situation, right. But in this situation, it don't bother me. You know what I'm saying?
Right. Because
nigga, you grew me in this YouTube shit, no matter how somebody say, because with certain steps I wasn't doing, you'd be like, nigga, you got to do it. I'm like, what? You'd be like, do it. And it worked.
And it bring us to arguments. Sometimes.
Oh yeah, I'm like, nigga, I ain't doing that shit, nigga. And he tell, and it works. So that's okay with me. We winning rings, nigga. Big ones. You know what I'm saying? We living great. Mm-hmm. It's because we work like that, man. This nigga gonna be Jordan, I'll be Pippen, I'll be that. That don't bother me, nigga. But, because we got the rings.
I appreciate that, brother.
Even though I look like Jordan, look like Pippen, ain't that crazy, but taller, ain't that wild though?
That gross, but
I'm just saying though, not Jordan's a little smooth nigga, nigga.
Come on, man. I'm just smooth, brother. You know what I'm saying? Relax. But last thing, like I say, like in that same, to piggyback off what you just said,
right.
The thing is, though, is Michael kept it pure. And
always.
The thing is, he went to Scottie and told him, like, hey, man, the Scottie wanted to quit on the last move.
Of course.
And then you missed those two, three
nigga
free
just
throws.
Just stay in the game,
and he
nigga.
Came, yeah, come on, brother, you got to be a decoy.
Right.
You know what I'm saying? But you wanted to tap out. You know, and the thing is, right. though, I've had moments like that with you where I'm like, three, hey, nigga, pick it up.
Right.
Let's go. It's go time.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
But in those moments, a lot of times, though, people understand to have that trait of I'm going no matter what.
Yeah, it's different.
I'm going to die by this shit.
Different.
Motherfucker got to go out on the shield, beat Deontay Wilder.
Yeah, shout
that's
out to
a,
him.
That's why I respect that nigga Deontay Wilder. That's why right. I respect Michael Jordan. You know what I'm saying? I got to go out on that shield, man. LeBron got that too.
Yeah.
But the thing is, though, let's skip out of that. Yeah. But anyway, man, the thing is, though, is like we've had conversations and where I've come to you and I'm like, hey, three, hey, listen, we got to go.
Right. I'm
you
know like, hold on, brother. No, ain't no hold on.
And the thing is, you're naturally a selfish person, like you said,
right?
And I'm naturally. I love the people I love.
Right.
You know what I'm saying? I don't love everybody.
Yeah.
But the thing is, because I'm really not even a people person, but I'm a people person, if that makes sense.
To your people.
To my people that fuck with me,
right.
I fuck with you.
Yeah.
It's to the end of time. Just like my supporters, like how you fuck with your supporters.
Oh, for sure.
You know what I'm saying? But the thing is, though, our natural relationship is you're selfish and I'm giving.
Right.
Right? But the thing is, though, is we've had conversations to where some of the stuff you've done has rubbed off on me and some of the stuff I've done has rubbed off on you.
No question.
And that's how it should be.
Yeah.
And Michael did that with Scotty. Scotty did that with Michael.
Right.
You'd be a damn fool. Look at the last 9-10 episodes. When he went and he was on his, Michael Jordan was on his last day because he was fucked up, food poisoning and all that.
Yeah.
What do you think he did? He went straight to, and Scottie was right there. Hey, come on, bro.
Let's go.
Let's go.
Let's go.
That's big goddamn three on his slim.
That's for sure. Like, even
you know
like
saying?
This, to get back, to piggyback back on the race situation, like, and I've been grinding, had a great month, you know, shout out to everybody that's supporting.
My big
merch.
Shout out.
I did a great month in merch and helped a lot of people with the donations and stuff I did with the mask, and I appreciate y'all buying extra stuff too. Cause not only did they buy masks, they'll buy some extra stuff too. So I was able to help people and, you know, do
everything
what,
count.
I had a great month. So, and Slim told, he just said, I think I feel you getting this rape this month, bro. We finna get you the rape. I'm like, what this nigga talking about?
Heart in my gut.
He said, and he kept, every time he go into a dealership, he bringing up the rape to the people. I'm like, nigga, hold on, brother. Not yet. Mm-hmm. Like, nigga, I'm telling you, finna get it. I can feel it, which is crazy. I'm like, man, whatever. Then we went through the ups and downs and getting approvals and got to take the cars. I'm like, man, fuck, this shit ain't gonna work. He's like, oh, you getting it, bro. I'm telling you, watch. And then I'm getting it. It's crazy. You was right, brother. You've been right every time. You know what I'm saying? And we're gonna continue to be right, man.
Likewise, let's go both ways, though.
Oh, yeah, for sure.
You know what I'm saying? But let's get into the news, brother. We went crazy.
Okay, we went new. Had to tap in, man.
Let's get into the news, man.
Yeah, top of the move news. Yeah.
Oh, we gotta talk about this.
Yeah.
Donald Trump, when he crazy on that lady.
Oh, well, that's my nigga. I'm telling you.
I ain't gonna lie. That's fucked up and ignorant, but it was some of the most hilarious shit
I've
ever seen.
Leave him alone, man. Quit playing with me.
Bro, what?
Ask China.
Okay? She said, why are you targeting me and saying that to me like that?
Just ask China. Because I'm, what you trying to say, baby? Ask China. China. Roasted her goddamn life. And deal with it.
He went nuts.
Get it in blood.
What's wrong with you?
Ask China. That nigga's crazy.
You know what's funny? The thing that makes it so crazy, and I see why, you know, a lot of people support it, is because the thing is, they're not really thinking so much about the internals of what he's going to do,
right,
or the racist shit or this. A lot of people are rocking with him because of the shit he say. And it's a lot of times like why people kind of fuck with you in a right. sense, because you say shit that people can't say.
Right.
You know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
So people rock with him because he say shit that they really want to hear.
And they, yeah, for
so,
sure.
Don't get mad at him for being the president, because there's a lot of undercover motherfucking racist, ignorant motherfuckers out there.
Damn right.
You know what I'm saying? Because they vocally may be saying publicly, I don't fuck with Trump, but behind
they,
the scenes,
they voted for him. They
voted
like
for him.
Yeah, because end of the day, man, there's no better feeling than being free and saying, doing what you want to do. But at the same time, that comes with a lot of ignorance, too. So yeah. You got to be cautious on that. Even though I say and do what I want a lot of time, I still walk a thin line before going overboard.
Donald
you know
Trump
what I'm saying?
Don't, he don't give a
he
fuck.
He don't give a fuck at all. That's pure top level white man mode on, in the flesh, baby. Because yeah. It's full top tier rich with the pure white man mold on it, man.
Right.
He don't give a goddamn, and he ain't gonna stand on it. Yeah. Get out of here, bitch. Just ask China. You
and
know what I'm saying?
Yeah, that was crazy. But and speaking of standing on something, let's talk about all the essential workers out there who laying their life on the line every single day.
They going hard, man. I know a few, you know, nurses and all that stuff. And
police officers.
Police officers.
People that work for the government.
Yeah, it's real. You know what I'm saying? The transit workers, the city bus drivers and all that good stuff. The garbage men.
Even Jeremy, he's essential. He works on the city buses. You know what I'm saying?
So like, you got to touch that shit.
Yeah. Like Kevin, my oldest brother, he does a city bus. He has a career in that, whereas my brother Jeremy is an engineer, works on the city buses. Ain't that crazy?
That is crazy.
One of my brothers driving, the other one works on the buses, an engineer. And then I got my brother, Officer Jones. Make sure you subscribe to Jeremy. Make sure you subscribe to Officer Jones, and make sure you subscribe to the Barrett World. You know, they got their family channel.
Oh, yeah, I saw that. Congratulations on that.
Yeah, for sure. And make sure you subscribe to Officer Jones' YouTube channel. But he's a police officer. One's an engineer, and the other one drives the buses. And they all work. They're all essential workers. And DJ's wife, Officer Jones, is a nurse.
Mm.
So that's what I'm saying. Think about that.
That is crazy.
Ain't that?
They two essential workers.
Yes,
and
together.
Just had a baby during this situation.
And just had a baby, bro. My niece, Zofia, man, she's so beautiful. And shout out to my brother, Jeremy. My niece, Kennedy, too. Real
that's
beautiful.
Crazy.
Yeah, doing big things, man.
My ex-girl that from back in the day, whatever, she lived in New York, and she just had a baby. And
I know you're talking about.
Yeah, she had corona while she had the baby. And actually, she had to do 5 tests. She did her 6 tests and finally got over. Now she could be back with the baby. Was away from the baby for 60 days.
But initially, didn't get to kiss the baby, hold
nothing,
the baby, nothing after delivery, right?
She had 5 positive tests.
Damn.
They're on the 6-1, finally got to see it after 60 days. So that shit real, you know what I'm saying?
It is.
Shit real in the field. Is there some finagle trickery on there? Type conspiracy theory, new world order control shit going on? Of course it is.
Right.
You know what I'm saying? Because this shit OD. Talking about some another 3 months here.
Get the fuck out of here. A little something on top.
It is some goddamn, yeah. Because imagine if somebody told you last year that, hey, next year the whole world going to shut down to a virus.
Right.
You
get
can't
the fuck
go
out
outside.
Here. Big
gonna,
contagion.
The government going to tell you you can't leave the house. Mm-hmm. Stay at home orders. Every business is going to shut down besides a grocery store.
It's crazy.
I was just reading yesterday. There's 20 million unemployed people in the state of California.
Alone.
There's been like 1,500 cases or something.
Right.
Like a couple hundred deaths.
Maybe. Come on, man.
Like, the blessing. The people that get to be essential workers is they got to lay their life on the line, but they still got a revenue to support their families.
Right, for sure.
And just speaking on the essential workers, I lost my whole train of thought when we started talking about everything.
Right.
But there was an explosion in downtown LA where it injured some firefighters.
The firemen, they was running, jumping off the goddamn thing. You got that video, champ?
So imagine that. They fighting for their life because they're essential too.
Oh, for sure.
They're fighting for their life as far as just trying to stay corona free and not bring it home to their people.
Right.
And when there's a building on fire and they got to go in there and risk their life with that.
That's crazy.
So it's like, man, they just fighting a war out there, all the essential workers,
shout
man.
Shout out to all the essential workers, nurses, police officers, it's everybody, man. We see y'all.
There's so much more
y'all.
Essential workers under that umbrella.
Straight up. Because yeah. I just got pulled over again. You seen that, but it was cool. You know what I'm saying?
Right.
And one dude
you
try
be getting
to
some good police. I'll be trying to get some the wrong ones,
but it's how I act, brother. You know what I'm saying?
No, it ain't always. Some niggas be, little, still be getting shot in their seatbelts sometimes.
I throw a little Uncle Tom on there, brother.
Yeah, you know what I'm saying? Oh, you change up so quick.
Oh, so quick.
That you would think Mr. Organic wasn't even there. It was just goddamn Jarvis Rivers.
Come on, brother. I'm a diabolical nigga, man. I don't get it fucked up now.
Yeah.
I ain't finna fight them. I know why. Listen, Genghis Khan said, never fight a war you can't win.
Right.
I know what I can win. I know I can't win, nigga.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? But
I'm too Michael. Like, you know how Michael Jordan had that brain? Like, I don't give a fuck about nothing. Yeah. He died with, even though he knew he couldn't beat Jerry Cross and the owner. Right. I think, nigga, just touch back on that. Boy, the owner, let's talk about the levels of life.
Right.
The owner, like how Michael Jordan's like, man, I'm still back. Why we couldn't go for seven. Michael, I fuck with you, but you'd have lost, brother. Next year, y'all would have lost.
Right.
You know what I'm saying? Sorry.
He was thinking deeper.
Yeah, he was thinking deeper. And I wish he would have, because then them motherfuckers could have seen he could lose in the finals, too.
Nope, they couldn't do him like that.
Yeah, that's why he ain't stayed with that. Come on, man.
He wasn't stupid.
He was going to lose in the finals, but he was going to take the legacy tank.
Listen, he ain't stupid.
Come on, man.
He stood on it, but he was like, that's the best way to go, too, on the side.
Yeah, on top. Even though in your head you think you did more, you were lost, brother.
Oh, for sure.
Sorry. But the thing is, though, to touch on that, though, the owner, at the end, he's just going to show you, he owned the Bulls and the White Sox, right?
For sure.
So understand the billions. Can we look up White Sox worth? Understand this, brother.
Yeah.
He owned both teams.
Of course.
Full billionaire way back then.
Right.
Man, look at Michael Jordan, his employee. So for us sure. Niggas, we look at Michael Jordan like, whoa, LeBron,
he's
like,
a
whoa.
Peasant.
But what?
You
big
can go.
Peasant compared to him.
You can go.
2.9 right now.
2.9 billion for the White Sox. That's now. But understand then, to own two teams, how sacked up you gotta be.
Yeah, he
and he
playing.
Didn't give a fuck. He all he cared about was the money.
He gave the business. Yeah, it was the business.
Yeah,
he was on.
I don't give a fuck about Michael Jordan. Black bald ass.
I don't want to pay you all that, buddy. I don't want to pay Steve Kerr. I don't want to pay Rodman.
Because he
I
knew he fucked Scottie Pippen, so he didn't want to pay him.
Yeah, you're out of here. We're going to die. We're going to roast you.
Yeah, we're going to get you.
We're going to roast you.
And you trying to stand on some shit with us?
We're
going to make
you.
An example. Yeah.
Traded your bum ass.
But he ended up going to Portland and getting like 90 million, 30 million,
I mean,
something
like
that.
Yeah, he went to Houston first, had a bad year.
Houston,
then,
yeah.
And then he went to Portland got his little bag.
And then he got the big
sacked up. He got his bag there.
You know what I'm saying? So the thing is, though, I just want to talk about the levels of life and how crazy that shit is. We look at Michael Jordan like, and don't get me wrong, he is iconic. So
now,
is LeBron.
Now he is. Got two
he
billion.
Was iconic back then, too.
He got billions now, so.
Yeah, but he was being sacked up then, too. It just wasn't on this level now.
Oh, of course not.
But the thing is, understand LeBron, too. LeBron worth a billions type right now.
In, like,
in
work,
playing
yeah.
game.
Yeah,
versus
they got, yeah, Nike
economies
gave him a
different
contract,
shit like
yeah.
that, all that shit. Yeah, 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 blah, blah. But he's still, in the playing years, Trump Jordan.
Oh,
on,
for sure.
On a lot of different aspects.
Yeah, money-wise, hell yeah.
And a lot of different things. You know what I'm saying? But he maybe just not in mentality and all that kind of shit.
Yeah.
In the championship,
but he ain't
whatever.
Got more money than right now.
Pretty close.
You want to do net worth? You going to, come on, brother.
Yeah, I know. We looked up Michael Jordan. It's like $3 billion something, right?
Yeah, and LeBron ain't got that.
He got at least a billion.
No, he don't.
Come on, man. Net worth. LeBron got at least a billion right
let's
now.
Let's see right, man. No. It's going to be like.
He signed $1 billion deal with just Nike alone.
You ain't got it, though. Nike,
so what?
That ain't got it.
So what? Michael Jordan didn't sign
Michael
$1 billion
Jordan, okay,
deal.
Michael Jordan signed a lifetime deal with Nike. He got $100 billion then because it's forever Jordan. The Jordan brand, he owned that. So
he
what are we talking about?
He only get $1 billion.
Huh?
He only get $1 billion.
Yeah, right. A year, nigga. He get $500 million a year from Nike.
Okay, well, we're going to go into a whole
for the rest
thing.
Of his life.
Let's
so
what
you want
to? Yeah, come on. So, okay. Michael, so is LeBron,
50, man. Pee on him, man. He a joke.
But in the end, he going to. Come on.
Going to do what?
I don't know.
We got Brand Jordan, brother. Ain't nothing copping that.
I thought he had $1 billion right now. I'm wrong.
Nah, it's all right.
So I'm trying to die by it. But listen,
yeah.
I don't want to, though. But listen, the thing is, though, is think about the levels of life. How that billionaire looked at Michael Jordan.
It's a joke.
He's like how we look at Michael Jordan. He looking at like you are my employee.
Oh, for sure.
I pay you.
Jerry Krause is looking at him like that too. They all can go. The Bulls
what
gonna be
the
here.
Fuck?
But they was wrong because the Bulls ain't been the same since.
Yeah, they was definitely wrong. But just go to give you an understanding of the levels of life.
Oh, we
you
always talk about that for
and
sure.
And how that owner, don't get me wrong, he got billions. There's somebody like Jeff Bezos make him look broke
all the time.
So if you ever searching for money and power for happiness, you would never,
never
be happy.
Never gonna get it. All it do is get you deeper into the hole, brother.
Yep.
Cause like now, okay, I got
get obsessed.
I'm getting a Wraith, but I'm getting a used one. Let's keep it organic. Then I'm like, damn, niggas buy them new. They look at you like you got a used one. Hey, motherfucker can say anything about everything.
But you've always
accepted
the bow down to the I'm gonna get the old finagle.
I knew
move.
I was gonna
you've
get that.
You always said that from the beginning.
Yeah, I ain't gonna say full finagle.
No,
it.
But it's not a finagle, nigga.
But
I'm
get
using
it,
your own words, brother. You said in a multitude of videos.
For sure. And now I get that, but I'm just saying it's levels to everything.
Right.
So you got to be happy within yourself first, or anything could crush you.
Correct.
You know what I'm saying? So you got to be secure and happy with yourself first.
Facts.
Then all the other shit add on to it.
Because you get that, you're just going to increase the misery.
You're going to be miserable because you're going to be like, damn, that ain't enough. So but you got to be secure with yourself. And I am, I know you are too. Yeah.
100%, man. But congrats again on the rave, brother. But I just want to talk about the levels of life.
Oh, for sure.
And we all know the Rolls Royce rave ain't no finagle.
Oh, no.
It's just, come on, brother. We know you had to go through to get in. The money had to get put down.
$400,000,
yeah. But the money had to go down, the payments. Come on,
ain't no regular mortal doing that.
Come on, man.
Speaking of life, levels of life, shout out to my dog Future, dropped a new album called High Off Life. You know what I'm saying? The two bangers I'm fucking with that on there is called Too Comfortable. You gotta listen to that. Don't get too comfortable.
Right.
It's hard. And then he got Accepting My Flaws. Crazy. And I was driving that, listen to that to go see the Rolls Royce. And the first line he's talking about rolling in the Rolls Royce. So I was already like, oh, then this song is crazy.
Right.
So shout out to Future and his new album. I'm fucking with it, man. He got a few bangers on there. Make sure you go ahead and listen to that, man.
Yeah, shout out to Moneybagg Yo. Go download his album.
Oh, yeah, he got a new album too. He bought your goddamn Urge, didn't he?
The Urge I was about to buy.
Damn, everybody was tagging me in that shit.
Everybody was tagging me and Jess. Yeah. Love It Slim. Go subscribe. Me and my woman's YouTube channel.
Yeah, shout out to Moneybagg Yo, man. I put you on him too, man. He hard.
You did.
His
years
flow
ago.
Is different. Bars, he cold.
And I fuck with him too.
He cold and motherfucker, man.
And we talking about the Hellcats, everything.
Everything.
Him, Moneybagg Yo, Lil Baby.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? Like, them my type. Like, and I fuck with Future too.
Yeah, but
I got
them
a lot of Future songs on my shit.
Yeah, see, Future, you know, he got not the full elements that you like, but them two got all the elements. They got the flows, they got the bars, got the concepts, and they got the realness in there too.
100%.
I fuck with them too.
Yeah, facts.
And I fuck with
Money
Man.
But let's talk about Lil Durk too, because I fuck with Lil Durk.
Lil Durk Heavy, his new album, Stupid too. Yep. I'm riding to that. That's some good riding
Midwest
music.
Midwest nigga.
Yeah,
just like myself.
Heavy, real nigga that transformed from a street nigga that would knock your noodles
his
out.
His dad for sure too. Him,
big,
both of them.
Yeah,
and it sprinkled down to him because he got it.
He'll knock your shit off quick.
Don't you ever think he ain't just like his dad?
He on camera letting it, you know what I mean?
Yeah.
He fighting that now type. You know what I'm saying?
He definitely got his dad blood in him.
Oh, he ain't playing. You know what I'm saying? With his little homie King Von, you know, he got numerous.
Yeah.
He got numerous bodies, they say, allegedly. You know what I'm saying? He on the street, so.
Is that tight? I don't know, bro.
He said, I got more hits than hits, nigga. Leave me alone. That's what he said to one nigga playing with him.
Okay, so he publicly threw that out the first.
Because they know. He didn't beat 2-3 cases, like went to court for years and beat them.
Right, okay.
And but they know they did it tight.
Yeah, okay.
He told niggas I got more hits than hits, so don't play with me, man.
Okay.
Yeah, leave him alone.
Yeah.
For real.
You know, another person I fuck with, too, that Lil Durk fuck with is T Grizzly. I fuck with him.
T Grizzly hard.
You know what I'm saying? I fuck with him.
Yeah, RIP to his aunt, man.
Yeah, for sure.
He hard. It's just something about his music and his flow, how he do that shit is dope. It is hard. It's hard. It's hard. I fuck with T Grizzly. I do, though.
Yeah, he cold nigga, man. I fuck with this shit too.
I fuck with T Grizzly, you know, man. His jury
that
game
third
is insane.
Person, him and Lil Durk went nuts.
Yeah, you like that joint.
That's my shit, nigga. I ain't gonna hold you.
I fuck with him. Shout out to T Grizzly.
They talking that talk, that real shit.
Real nigga shit.
Don't play with me, man.
Right, because it's whatever come with it.
I hate to have to do it.
Yeah, but I will.
But I'm gonna stand on it.
I do it again, too.
Come on, man.
Do it once, do it twice, do it three times.
Yeah, and another nigga who I fuck with, who you put me on to, like Moneybagg Yo, Money Man.
Money Man, that nigga.
I fuck with that nigga.
I'm gonna tell you why I fuck with that nigga, because he's an intellectual, motherfucking, health and wealth brain nigga.
Yep.
If you want to get some goddamn giblets,
Money Man.
And just play it through. And just ride to that nigga. He gonna tell you all type of cryptic codes, water fasting, grow your own crops, get the money here. That nigga ain't playing.
Facts.
Fuck with Money Man. And he's so independent, so he don't even care. He just put it out himself, and he gonna grind it up on the back wave.
He said,
I don't like doing shows. I don't like doing concerts, man. I just wanna do what I do and sit back.
Yeah.
That's how I play. I don't promote my shit and not just put it out organically.
He
don't care.
Yeah, you gotta know him to know him.
He said, I just put it on and record my shit and put it out. He said, I don't be knowing my words or nothing. He said, that's why I hate doing shows. I don't be knowing my words.
Oh, that's cold nigga right there.
He just a different brain nigga, man.
Yeah.
Listen to Money Man. If you and that nigga cold.
Yeah, he a top level nigga. I fuck with him.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? You put me on his music. But download all his music on there.
For sure.
But I think where I get like a good mix of Money Man's music is when I go on Pandora.
Yeah.
Right?
Yeah.
And they go from his old shit all the way to his new shit. Just a sprinkle of Money
just jumping
Man.
Around.
And that's where I've got my best giblets with him at.
And shout out to my nigga Mozzie too. He dropped his new album.
Mozzie.
Beyond Bulletproof.
Mozzie's
you know
supposed to be on here.
Yeah, he's supposed to be a shot to Mozzie, man. He got busy and shit because he got to promote his album. That nigga got that verbiage, man. He got that talk like we talk.
Yeah, he quick talk too.
He went all the extra
money.
Yeah, Slimer with the goddamn facilitator.
He says everything.
He got all the verbiage, man.
With the linger of every goddamn ERs and S's at the end.
Yeah, he be on it. And he a real nigga, man.
You ever watch when Mozzie went to the complex, got the shoes?
Oh, hilarious. Be one of the funniest shits ever because he got all the verbiage. Let me get those. Those was two goddamn lawyer type.
Too catastrophic. Them is too atomic.
Yeah, every time. I fuck with him. And then you all that.
Like a little nuclear plant.
Yeah, I can kill. Slimy.
I fuck with him.
Shout out to Maji, man.
I fuck
real
with
nigga,
for sure.
Man.
And another thing I seen that he did, I fuck with too, is you know how he's gonna pick up the homeless people.
Right.
He's suiting them, booting them up, hooking them up with bread. He always giving homeless motherfuckers money and shit.
Yep.
Black motherfucking homeless motherfuckers too.
Yeah, you know helping them out, man. Feeding the people.
Yeah, for sure. So I fuck with Maji too.
Yeah, shout out to Maji, man.
Yeah, he got the whip game too.
Oh, you're heavy. Oh,
but yeah.
We got a finagler alert. So this dude off goddamn, what was it? Love and Hip Hop.
Yeah.
This motherfucking, so what's his nigga name, man? saying?
Arkansas Mo.
Arkansas Mo for Nagler. He got a trucking company.
Yep.
Using the people money to pay the what's that? The protection. What is it?
The paycheck.
The paycheck protection act. Helping people.
Which
that,
a lot of companies are.
Yeah. So who got companies helping their employees make sure you're paying them so they can
on
eat?
On a much smaller level, it's like what Delta got from the government to keep them in business to pay their employees.
Yeah. So he took
the money and ran off with the plug.
Yeah. He got the checks and started balling out, getting rapes and goddamn silk robes and getting his toes done with goddamn maggots and shit like that, sucking the feet. He got 2.1 M from that shit, nigga.
That's crazy.
And when the feds raided his house, he had 80,000 in
cash. And you a nigga, brother. When you a black nigga, know how to move, brother. You know they gonna watch you over everybody else. You know all the other motherfuckers running off with that money. You can't do that as
but
no black
thinking,
man.
Like, man, they ain't paying attention to me.
Right, and wrong.
They always pay attention. Definitely right now, because you understand they arresting niggas with too much goddamn N95 mask.
All right.
You know what I'm saying? Trying to goddamn get that back weight money.
Mother got
so you
too
don't
much
think they pay attention where their money going right now?
Oh, for sure.
The whole goddamn world is in a bind right now.
It's a shame.
And so if they give a motherfucker millions, even hundreds of thousands, man, let me see what this nigga doing.
Let me watch him.
Definitely a black nigga.
Definitely a black nigga.
That's what I'm saying.
In Atlanta, too, the scamminest niggas in the world. Shout out to my Atlanta niggas, but you know how y'all move.
You should have did right with your people, man.
Come on, brother. You know I'm saying? Goddamn
shit. Not to say that he didn't, but.
Do you see that Mike Tyson shit? Unless you see my nigga Mike Tyson looking ferocious.
Oh, that nigga, hey, boy, that nigga will kill you still.
He gonna get knocked out for 30 seconds, though. He got 20 seconds in doing that, then he gonna.
I ain't gonna lie to you. You know how Michael Jordan said, you get older, you get wiser with the moves, and I think Mike got that, brother. I'm gonna keep it pure with you.
Listen up, brother. They look vicious.
Don't get me wrong, he getting there with Tyson Fury.
Look at that
game over.
Bah, come on, nigga. Rude. If he hit nigga like that, if he hit nigga with this right here, bop, 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 boom, boom, and hit him with this.
But that
bam.
Look cool on some regular nigga shit.
Okay, that's 10,
like,
that's
for
10
us
seconds.
Regular people.
But can he go 10 rounds?
I'm gonna tell you who gave the best take on this. Max Kellerman through ESPN.
Yep.
You know he a boxing guru
bam.
Nigga.
Boom. Ooh, don't do it like that, Mike. Look at the body. Bah, bah, bah,
so
bah,
wait,
bah,
tell me
bah,
this. Bah, bah. Deontay Wilder and Mike Tyson right now.
Because he get hit, he gonna die though.
But who gonna win?
If Deontay hit him, he's gonna go to the hospital, might not come out.
But how you know he ain't gonna come out like Tyson Fury?
Anybody should do that to Deontay Wilder, man. He's 40, man, and then knock out.
I ain't gonna lie, I believe Deontay Wilder gonna knock him the fuck
come
out.
On, man.
But I'm just saying.
But he hit a nigga with that, though. He just gotta get that off. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
I don't think he gonna. And he got.
I ain't gonna lie. Deontay Wilder might punch that nigga brain
that's what
out
I'm
his
saying,
skull.
He gonna kill him, bro. He gonna put that nigga.
That nigga one time he's gonna fly out the back of his goddamn skull.
He gonna kill him, brother. So.
And definitely right now, no. Whoever fights Deontay Wilder next, if it ain't Tyson Fury, I feel bad for you, champ.
Yeah, because he gonna
try to kill somebody in the ring for real this
you
time.
Know what would be a good fight with Mike Tyson? I know they've been talking about it. It's Shannon McCannon. Shannon the Cannon Briggs. Yeah, Shannon.
Champ! Let's go, champ. That would be a good one.
Yeah, but see, when Chip, like 4 years ago, when he was in super shape and all that, before he got caught with the steroids,
yeah,
I think it would have been a good fight. Now he's been out of shape for years. He off it, you know what I'm saying? But it was the Shannon
I think
the Cannon.
Be good.
If it was the Shannon the Cannon 4 years ago, it would have been a legendary bout.
Yeah.
But not
I remember
now.
When you first told me about him.
That's my nigga, man.
That's crazy because we was always saying champ, and I didn't even know who he was.
Yeah, that's where he got from. Let's
go,
champ.
Right?
That's that nigga, man. I ain't gonna hold you like them old videos 3-4 years ago.
But I'm talking about before I even met you, even when I used to call Ethan champ.
And, yeah.
You know what I'm saying? Like I never knew where it even came from. You know what I'm saying? Like, well, what made me say it? Or I don't know where I've ever heard it.
Right.
You know what I'm saying? So it's like
yeah,
oh,
that's the champ, bro. Shannon the Cannon, goddamn Briggs, man. That's the man with the master plan. I fuck
so
him.
Who do you think between Mike Tyson, because they were talking about like Mike Tyson and Evander do another fight.
I don't think he won't know Evander, man. Evander be beating his ass too much. He probably get him now, though. I don't know, because he beat the shit out of both of them times. Bad, too. He can't fuck with no Evander.
But I think right now he might be simmering
down.
Evander
big, and Evander fought way longer than him, got the shit beat out of him and all that goddamn bankruptcy on the brain and all that. I don't know if he could take it. I think Tyson will whoop him now.
I think so, too.
But I don't know.
But because Evander do got a different type of blood.
Because he different diabetic warrior.
Yeah, for
he
sure.
beat the dog shit out of him both times. Had to bite the chunk out the ish near.
Yeah, type got frustrated. He was like, man, I just got
to
kill him.
So I don't know, man. I don't know. It's tough, man.
Yeah.
But,
Well, let's go to the Apple podcast reviews. First, we're going to go with the IG question.
Let's do that.
You know what I'm saying? So let's hear it, BG.
All right, we got this one's from Gary Love 2245. He said, if you guys each had $1 million to make your own custom build, you can just go buy something for $1 million, but if you had to build something up for $1 million, where would you kind of start? Where would you go with it?
Build something up with $1 million? Do you just get to get $1 million and whatever remainder you get to keep? If we talking about that, I'm
you got
Hellcat.
$1 million to build you a car, bro. Yeah. What you gonna build?
Well, he's not dope, but I think you gotta spend it.
You gotta spend it.
Yeah, Brewster's millions, man. You
okay,
gotta spend it, bro.
You don't get to spend it. If you get the pocket of change, I'm going Hellcat. You know what I'm saying? But if you go a million and you get to build it, I ain't gonna lie. I'm probably going SVJ Roadster, Lamborghini, Aventador SVJ Roadster, or like, you know what I mean? I might type just go Bugatti right from the seed and just, you know, just have a $1 million move. It gotta be type new one, though, not the old finagle joint. know what I'm saying?
I don't know if them a meal.
I mean, the mill? Oh, the old ones, type 800,000, a little more.
Yeah, you can't do that one.
Yeah, I ain't gonna lie. I gotta go Lamborghini Aventador SVJ Roadster and build that joint up. What you doing?
I'm going Rafe, what I already got, and build that bitch
Congratulations,
up.
Congratulations, bro. Yeah, that talk is crazy. I already got that, so I'm gonna just go with
yeah,
that.
Yeah, yeah. This is my favorite car, man. It's just. Yeah. The Rafe.
Yeah. Congratulations. Thank you. So now we got the Apple reviews. Make sure you go over to Apple reviews.
5-star.
Drop a 5-star on there, man. 3M, go ahead and read that one, brother.
We got Juvie Wee, whatever his name is, man. I don't know how to say that, but he says, keep up the legendary journey. I've been watching y'all since Tall Guy's Life Story and Mr. Organic, a.k.a. 3M, had the GT Challenger. Watched you guys grow over the years. Have been very inspirational, and I appreciate the organic rawness y'all put out there. Stay blessed.
Yeah, appreciate you, Champo.
Oh, this the Rafe man right here calling me now. Oh,
okay. Well, you got hold on. We almost done, brother.
Yeah, well, hold on.
Okay, call him right back.
Come on, man.
Fuck it, go ahead and answer. We got to talk to him. Put him on speaker.
Yo, Adam.
Yes, sir.
What's going on, Champ?
All right, I'm going to text you my address where I've got that G63 and the McLaren 2.
Okay.
So hopefully you can have some fun.
Oh, yeah, definitely.
It's my house, but you're more than welcome.
Thank you. I appreciate that, Champ.
What else was I going to tell you? Cashier's check to Amazon Leasing, Inc.
Okay.
And what else was I going to say?
You was going to say where Tall Guy Lambo at, brother. You got all my information now.
I'm with Tall Guy right now.
What was I going to say? I'm speaking with Corey, and right now I've got one of my guys processing all the dogs so I can get his done, too.
Oh, shit. See, Adam, you the man. You making both of our dreams come true at the same time, man. I appreciate you, man.
Top of the Move podcast, man.
For real, though, man. I super appreciate you, man. You worked some magic. You worked it quick, man. I'm looking forward to handing you this big old check.
Corey and I were going back and forth. I don't know, 10, 11 o'clock last night?
Oh, yeah, he don't play around, man.
I think he was the last email or text I saw before passing out.
Sound like me.
That sound like him, man. I told you, as soon as you get me done, he's coming too, man. So
coming
I'm a man
for the neck, juggler.
Yeah, I'm a man of my word, and you are too, man, and so is he.
What are the benefits of being single? I guess you can work stupid hours.
Damn right. You damn right. You can work to your bone.
I'm looking at
but you'll also see that part of the craziness, and Corey will attest to...
Lights went out.
I was all on top, and then it turned out to be a crazy weekend. My house is in escrow and closing this week.
Uh-oh, some big millions.
Congratulations.
And I don't know where I'm going. So it's been... I thought I was going to have to be out tomorrow, but I asked them to push it back a week, so...
They'll give you a little bit of time.
Trying to figure out, where am I going?
You're going to the top, brother. You're already there. You're going to go up to the top of the MOOC.
So tell me, we good to pick that joint up, man?
We're going to what?
We good to take delivery of that Rafe today? Are we good?
The Rafe? I got to get I'm waiting for the inspection back, and I'm waiting for the payoff docs from the seller, but payoff, it should be this week you'll get it.
Okay, for sure. We'll get it done, man.
Okay, well, we'll figure that out. The logistics when we done.
Yes, sir.
Did both of you guys do the, did both of you guys do a video or?
Oh, yeah, for sure. We both did it.
Follow anything.
So yeah, you got it. I send you the link to the one I put up when I went to go check it out. You'll love it.
Right. Please.
All right, I'll do that. And let's text me that information, man. We on the way.
And we'll call you. He'll call you back as soon as we done over here, Adam.
What'd you say?
He gonna call you back as soon as we done over here with this podcast.
Okay, call me because I got a couple questions for you about wheels too.
All right, okay. Go on.
Thanks, bye.
Yeah. All right, so y'all caught it there first. That's why y'all rock with Top of the Move podcast.
There you
caught
go,
there
man.
First live and in the flesh and hot as all went down. Because I was about to ignore the call, but he answered and now look at what y'all heard.
There
man.
You go, man. I heard that.
Live 5-star review, man. The Bobby Pearson. That's who it came from. G-Squad and Gargoyle Gang. What's happening? Huge fan of you guys. Support all the way from Atlanta. This podcast is the ultimate man cave barbershop talk there is. Factuals.
Big
the
time.
Conversations that happen are relatable and inspiring. I salute you guys. And whenever y'all come to L or whenever y'all come to the A, lunch on me, LOL. I appreciate y'all, man. Appreciate you, Champo.
Shout out to Bobby Pearson, brother. 5-star. We appreciate you, Champ Pizzle.
Mm-hmm.
YouTube real quick, and that's a wrap.
Yeah, sure.
Got the YouTube coming. We got to get that today.
Right. Yeah, but you gotta do the motherfucker special now. You gotta make sure that motherfucker always top tier though.
That's gonna be all right.
I know. do it after I already got it type.
Come on, man. Hey, viral. Something happened.
Right.
Hopefully it ain't just like death tape.
Yeah, do that. Yeah. Man, we know DDE. They got niggas that can
come
fix
on,
it up.
Man. Yeah, shout out to them. All right, we good. Who's that? You talking about Jason Fuller?
Yeah.
Go ahead, get the 3-0.
All right, Jason Fuller said, bro, I love you both, man, all your energy that you give. I just want to remind you guys that the skies are not the limit. You guys are proving it every day on all your platforms. Big muscle, muscle, muscle. Thank you. You're welcome, champ.
Yeah, appreciate you, Jason Fuller.
Jason Fuller. Hold on. Fuller, is that whatchamacallit? From Minnesota? No, I ain't him, because I see him. No, no.
Okay.
You know, that's a guy who's working at 43 Hoops. Remember that? The tall dude and his dad, the bigger type dude. His last name is Fuller, too.
Yeah, but his first name ain't Jason.
Okay, yeah. Then his name was Jeff. It's Jeff Fuller.
Yeah, that's him.
Yeah.
Yep, he be running the AAUs.
Yep, him.
Yep, yeah, I know you're talking
get
about.
Get that little check.
But that's it. That's all, y'all. What episode we on now?
17.
Episode 17. That's a wrap. That's all. See y'all in the next episode. Tall Guy, my dog, Mr. Organ. Subscribe to both of our channels. Man, yes, we up out of here, man.
3 of the guy. We out of here.
3 of
every time she see me, she just cracks a smile.
Nigga. 3 of them. 3 of them. Worthless ass niggas.